It's a whole lot of unknown writers and performers, and I was one of them. Nobody much knew that we were around, and nobody much cared. That is, nobody but Sue Brewer. She opened her door, her pocketbook, and her heart to all of us. And it was at her place, we called it the Boer's Nest, that we used to get together and pick and sing and just hang out. Well, tonight, some of us are back together again at Sue's Boer's Nest to honor her and remember the important part that she played in our lives.
The door is always open with our host, Waylon Jennings, and Waylon's guest, Richie Albright, Hank Cochran, Jesse Coulter, Little Jimmy Dickens, Harlan Howard, George Jones, Merle Kilgore, Kris Kristofferson, Led Lane, Basil McDavid, Roger Miller, Willie Nelson, Mickey Newberry, Webb Pierce, Buck Trent, Mac Vickery, Hank Williams Jr., Mac Wiseman, and Farron Young.
Yes, the door is always open, and the light's on in the hall, and you know that I'll be waiting if you ever come to call.
Thank you. Well, right here, they had a bunch of cue cards that they wanted me to read, but guess what? I ain't going to. Now, I'll tell you, this show means much too much to me for me to try to read it. I'd just like to try to tell you what it means to me myself in my own words. Sue Brewer was a friend of mine, and she was a friend to just about everybody that's on this show tonight. We all loved her very much then, now, and we always will. She was a great friend to the new songwriters and new singers that came to town, and the Songwriters Guild is helping to establish a Sue Brewer Fund that we're going to try to open another door again, like it was at Sue's house, for all the new songwriters that come to town in Nashville. That's what it's all about. I met this fella in Phoenix, Arizona, and he was doing a series of one-nighters, and I was working at a nightclub there, and he came to see me. Now, I told him I'd been offered an RCA contract if I'd moved to Nashville. And Nashville, Willie had been around Nashville for quite a little while. And that's right. And he was already a star as a singer, a songwriter, and even a TV star. But he told me what I should do about it. And I listened to him, and he told me I shouldn't move. And sure enough, I took his advice, and I moved. Right now, here's the best there is, Willie Nelson.
Illinois Central, Monday morning rave. 15 cars and 15 restless riders. 3 conductors and 25 sacks on me. All along the southbound Odyssey, the train pulls out from Kankakee and rolls along past houses, farms, and fields. Graveyards full of old black men and the graveyards of rusty automobiles. Good morning, America, how are you? Hey, don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train they call the city of with the old man in the club car. Any a point, there ain't no one keeping score. Pass the paper bag that holds the bottle and feel the wheels rumbling beneath the floor. Darkness rolling down to the sea. But the houses and the people seem to fade into a bad dream. And the steel rails still ain't heard the news. Conductors sing your songs again, and passengers will please refrain. This train has got the disappearing railroad blues.
Thank you, Billy. Thank you. He's great. We'll be back in a few minutes.
Some have said down through history, if you last, it's a mystery. But I guess they don't know is what they're talking about. Down to the sea, you become such a habit with me. America, America. Well, I come from down round Tennessee, but the people in California are nice to me. America. It don't matter where I may roam, tell you people that it's home sweet home. America, America. And my brothers are all black and white, yellow too. And the red man is right to expect a little from you. A promise and then follow through. America.
the men who fell on the plains and who lived through hardship and pain. America, America. And the men who could not fight in a war that didn't seem right, you let them come home. America.
And it needs people like Sue Brewer to make melodies happen. We'll be right back with some more of Waylon's friends, Hank Williams Jr. and Kris Kristofferson, right after this. Thank you.
Hank Williams was on the Grand Ole Opry radio show. I thought the world had come to an end. I thought he was just about it. Well, I've got a friend who's become a legend in his own rights and on his own. Here's my good friend, Hank Williams Jr.
Preacher man says it's the end of time. Mississippi River is a going prime. The interest is up and the stock market's down. And you only get mugged if you go down.
Well, I'm supposed to read a cue cards again, but guess what? I ain't gonna do it again. They had some things written out that about, and they were nice about Chris, but I gotta tell you a real true story, and it's concerning Chris and Sue Brewer. One time Sue came to me and she said, Waylon, says, I'm worried about Chris. Said, he's hanging out with losers, and says, I don't think he's ever gonna make it. Says, you gotta go talk to him. And I couldn't figure out what in the world to say to him because I was the one he was hanging out with. Chris Christopherson, come out here, Hart.
Everybody I was under hanging out with was on his payroll. Hey, I want to say a couple of words just about Sue Brewer and the Boar's Nest and what it meant to us, all the people who are working here tonight. Because there's a few special shrines to the soul of the country music that we love so much that we committed our lives to it. And like the old Ryman Auditorium and Tootsie's and Lime Boss and Sue Brewer's Boar's Nest, which was for a whole bunch of us the most important one because it was a place that an artist who wasn't commercial yet could show his work to an audience that mattered. And if it hadn't been for that Boar's Nest, I know I would never have written the songs that I did. So so I feel very grateful to Sue. And I got a new song for you, honey. It's brand new. And I just showed it to the band when we got on stage. So we're gonna try it.
Hey, old friend, I was dreaming about you today, and I couldn't help wondering what you'd have to say if I told you that sometimes I still feel the same.
Different than we were back then, huh, Hoss?
Hoss, they were different back then. But some things never change.
Right. Steve.
See him wasted on the sidewalks in his jacket and his jeans, wearing yesterday's misfortunes like a smile. Once he had a future full of money, love, and dream, but you spoke like they was going out of style. And he keeps right on a changing for the better or the worse, searching for a shrine he's never found, never knowing if believing is a blessing or a curse, or if the going up was coming down. He's a poet, he's a picker, he's a prophet, he's a pusher, he's a pilgrim and a preacher, and a problem many
in every wrong direction on his lonely way back home. He has tasted good and evil in your bedrooms and your bars. He traded in tomorrow for today, running from his devil's lord and reaching for the stars, losing all he loves along the way. But if the world keeps right on turning for the better or the worse, all he ever gets is over and around. From the rocking of the cradle to the rolling of the hearse, the going up was worth the coming down. He's a poet,
he's a liar,
he's a prophet,
he's a dreamer,
he's a pilgrim and a preacher, and a problem when he's stoned. He's a walking contradiction, partly truth and partly fiction, taking him the wrong direction on his lonely way back home.
Get it all back together if you'll just wait a minute right after this commercial message.
Sue Brewer managed Possum Holler, and that was George Jones's nightclub here in Nashville. And we used to all hang out there hoping we'd get to hear our favorite singer, George Jones. Because if we could all sound like we wanted to, we'd all sound like George Jones.
Mistakes like anyone else.
And don't you point your finger at nobody.
Lord, it's plain to see that you ain't no saint yourself.
She's the rock that I lean on.
She's the sunshine of my day.
And I don't care what you say about.
Lord, took me and made me everything I am today. She's my rock and I ain't gonna throw away. Hey, she's my rock and I ain't gonna throw away.
Yeah, she's my rock and I ain't gonna throw away.
Now I want to introduce a poor little ugly thing that just barely can sing. Somebody that means a whole lot to me. She's Shooter's mama. She's my better half.
Jesse Coulter.
Our next singer is a writer and a wit and a good friend of mine, Roger Miller.
Do the mornings still come early? Are the nights not long enough? Does a tear of hesitation fall on everything you touch? Well, it might just be a lesson for the hasty heart to know. Maybe leaving's not the only way to go. Maybe laying, let your feelings grow accustomed to the dark, and in wordless conversation solve the problems of the heart. Well, it might just be a lesson for the hasty heart to know. Maybe leaving's not the only way to go. People reach new understandings all the time. They take a second look and maybe change their minds. People reach new understandings every day. Tell me not to reach, babe, I'll go away. Do the mornings still come early? Are the nights not long enough? Does a tear of hesitation fall on everything you touch? Well, it might just be a lesson for the hasty heart to know. Maybe leaving's not the only way to go.
Thank you.
I was another one of Sue's struggling songwriters in the early 60s, and I remember that Sue not only worked nights as manager of George Jones' Possum Hollow, but she also worked for Farron Young's Music City News to help support all of us. Our only acts that were working in those days were Farron Young and Webb Pierce, who came by with the groceries now and then to help out. Now let's help buy some groceries for some of the struggling songwriters who are around here today. And take a listen.
This is a place where we all hung out, Sue Brewer's. We called it the Boar's Nest back in the days. We thought we might have a little fun trying to recreate the time back in the mid-60s. So you come along with us. You might hear a song that you might recognize from that day and time. And don't be surprised if the room's grown a little bit, because I think we have too, maybe. Now, what... What we have here is commonly known as a organized riot. And this first guy, when I first met Chris Christopherson, he was really shy. In a loud sort of way, you know. And I think he's still just about the same old hoss. Right here he is, Chris Christopherson.
Well, thank you, Willie. Listen, the thing that was so important about Sue's place in the Boar's Nest for people like me and Vince and all of us, but it was the only place that we had to show what we were doing to an audience that mattered, and people whose opinions we respected, you know. And if it hadn't been for that place, that was the only thing we had to get. The only positive feedback I had for like 4 years. I'd have gone before I ever wrote a song that was worth a lick, you know. This is one of them that I wrote back then. He said humbly, as I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head that didn't hurt. The beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. George looks away at me. Then I fumbled through my closet for my clothes and found my cleaning's dirty shirt. I washed my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I'd smoked so much the night before, my mouth was like an ashtray I'd been licking. That's the way I wrote it. I lit my first and watched a small kid cussing at a can that he was kicking. Then I crossed the empty street, caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And it took me back to something that I'd lost somehow, somewhere along the way. On the Sunday morning sidewalk. What a sorry looking bunch. Wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. There's something in a Sunday makes a body feel alone.
God, there's a word.
Getting depressing. There ain't nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound on the sleeping city sidewalks. Sunday morning coming down.
Thank you.
Yeah. One of the oldest and dearest friends that Sue Brewer ever had, I'm sure, was Webb Pierce. And I imagine Webb's got a million stories that he could tell us, but I'm just gonna turn it over to you.
I know a lot of times I'd be lonely, you know. And I'd go up there and visit with her at a place, and I knew I'd get to see maybe George Jones or Waylon Jennings or Willie Nelson. Hey, you were too young, Hank. I don't know if you were there many times.
Kilgore took my place.
Merle Kilgore, yeah. And in fact, me and Merle wrote a song up there one night. He wrote it and I cut him in on it. Anyway, every once in a while, Sue would say, "Hey, we got to lighten up the place. That it's about time to have the national anthem for the Boar's Nest." So I'd sing this song. There stands the glass that will ease all my pain, that will settle my brain. Brother, I'm on my way. While I'm wondering where you are tonight, and I'm wondering if you are all right, I wonder if you think of me in my misery. There stands the glass, fill her up to the brim, until my troubles grow dim. It's my first one today. How about a little picking, Willie? Enough to spur a fella on. I'm wondering where you are tonight. I'm wondering if you are all right. I wonder if you think of me in my misery. You did hear spur, did you?
Yes, I did.
There stands the glass. Oh, fill it up to the brim. Until my troubles grow dim. It's my first one to take.
That's great. That's great.
This next guy was as much a fixture at Sue Brewer's house as a couch or a chair. In fact, he was skinny back then, and we used to sit on him. Mac Vickery.
Amen. God bless you, buddy. Thank you, brother. Speaking of skinny, sometimes were and sometimes wasn't. Thank God for the skinny times because that makes the fat ones look better. Streak of lean, streak of fat, skinny gums on a streak of that. I want to thank you for helping me on this song. I had a gal in Cedar Town, Georgia. I used to walk nearly 3 miles of Georgia Swamp, Dakota.
Hey.
She never had much, just a sharecropper's daughter. I married her and took her down to New Orleans. I rent a little home in the South French Quarter. Sweet honky tonk wine. I know you didn't record us, Waylon, but Mickey did. So did Jerry Lee. Somebody had to show Mickey how to sing. Thank you, Mickey. Putting it in the Urban Cowboy movie. You can cut that part out if you want to. Honky-tonk wine.
Oh,
why don't you know that it keeps me out of my M-I-N-D mind, Lord. All she left behind is a little bit of sweet. $1.28, get you 7-Eleven store. Honky tonk wine.
Oh. Stay tuned. tune for Waylon and Friends right after this brief
kiss. That sounded awful formal, didn't it? Well, what we used to do, one of the other things we used to do when we'd hang out at Sue Brewer's house is go by and listen to Willie Smile. Willie Nelson.
Well, I had a couple of memories of Sue Brewer and the Boar's Nest. I loaned one of them to Roger. Because he didn't have any at all. But I'd like to do this song for Sue. Because I'm sure she's been through a lot of this with all of us. Well, I gotta get drunk and I sure do dread it, because I know just what I'm gonna do. Start spend my money, call it everybody honey, and wind up singing the blues. I'll spend my whole paycheck on some old wreck, and brother, I could name you a few. Well, I have got to get drunk, and I sure do dread it, cause I know just what I'm gonna do. Well, I gotta get drunk, and I can't stay sober. There's a lot of good people in town. They'd like to hear me holler, see me spend my dollars, and I wouldn't think of letting them down. There's a lot of doctors that tell me I better start slowing it down. But there's more old drunks than they are old doctors, so I guess we better have another round.
All right. Well, thanks to Willie now, my one-liner I was going to use to introduce Roger is gone. He does that a lot on stage, too. Anyway, here's Roger Miller.
Where? I didn't realize I was here. It's a song
that
I'll have to kill you. It's the song I wrote about the time hanging around the Boar's Nest. Had some lonely hours myself. In the summertime when all the trees and leaves are green and the redbird sings, I'll be blue, cause you don't want my love. Some other time that's what you say when I want you, then you laugh at me and make me cry, cause you don't want my love. And you don't seem to care a thing about me, you'd rather live without me than to have my arms around you when the nights are cold, you're so all alone. Trees and leaves are green and the redbird sings, I'll be blue, cause you don't want my love.
I'll tell you now, this next guy's a mess.
Uh-oh.
You know, when we first come to Nashville, I mean, I remember it was me, and I think most of them, too. You know, if you could get... The obstacle to get past was fair and young. If you could live over... If you could mentally get over what he said to you, then you could make it to business.
I was good to you.
You were great to me. You were great to everybody. Here's fair and young.
I love you. Thank you, Waylon. Everybody's talking about Sue. Now, Sue was really responsible for my biggest hit record. It was two people, Willie Nelson, he wrote it. But I took the song out to the Boar's Nest, and a few of you guys were sitting around, and I sang it, and everybody laughed. He's going around saying, hello, commode, hello, bathtub, hello, sink. Where did you get that terrible piece of material? And I sang it to Sue. She said, that's a hit, honey. You cut that thing. And me and you laughed all the way at the bank, didn't we? Yeah.
I tried to sell it to you one time. Remember that?
He did. He tried to sell me Hello Walls for $500. Because I told him how many it had sold. He thought I was hyping it, you know. I said, no, don't you sell this song. I'm going to loan you some money. And I loaned him the money. And about 6 weeks later, he got another check for like $20,000. I was sitting at Tooses, and this arm came around my neck, squeezed my mouth open, and he French kissed me. And it was the best kiss I ever had.
I don't believe it.
And we've been close ever since.
I was going to pay you that $400 back one time when I had it, and he wouldn't take it. He said, no, you raise me a cow, and whenever that calf gets up old enough to butcher, will you give her to me? She's about 7,000 pounds.
Yeah, well, so that calf weighs over 7,000 pounds. Give me a car. Let's see if we can do this. Well, hello, Walls.
I think she'll go for you today. I taught you better than it. Now don't you miss her. Keep going. Then she up and walked away. And I'll bet you dread to spend another lonely night with me. But lonely walls, I'll keep you company. You remember the second part?
Hello, Wenda.
You remembered it.
Well, I see that you're still here. Aren't you lonely? Since our darling disappeared. Well, look here, is that a teardrop in the corner of your pane?
Sings it just like I taught it.
Now, don't you try to tell me that it's rain.
Well, she went away and left us all alone. The way she planned, I guess we'll have to learn to get along without her if we can. Sing it.
Hello, Celia.
I'm gonna stare at you a while. You know I can't sleep. So won't you bear with me a while? We've got to all stick together, or else I'll lose my mind. I've got a feeling she'll be gone a long, long time.
Stay tuned for more of Old Waylon and Friends, and the door is always open.
This next guy, you know, used to call partying roaring back in them days.
Yeah.
And now here's the king of the roarers, Buck Trent.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Waylon. It's good to be here. And I was thinking, the first time I met Sue was in 1963 in Tulsa. Played Kane's Ballroom, and just as I come off the stage, she walked right at my face and said, when you take me out for a late night stack, I want you to bring that banjo with you. So every time I'd see her after that, she'd say, Buck, don't forget that banjo. Don't forget the banjo, Buck. So here's a tune I wrote called Banjo Buck.
Another friend of Sue Brewer's is Little Jimmy Dickens. And y'all might not know this, but you know that Little Jimmy Dickens is 2 inches taller than Crystal Gill's hair? Jimmy Dickens.
Can I stand up?
You got it.
I used to go by Our Lady Sue's house because I was downtown and wasn't sure whether I was in shape to drive home or not. And I'd go there, and she'd hide my keys and said, you're not leaving till you sing something that makes me hurt. And so I'd sing this. Why must you always try to make me over? Take me as I am, or let me go. White lilies never grow. on stalks of clover. Take me as I am, let me go. You're trying to reshape me in a mold's love. In the itch of someone you used to know. And I won't be a stand-in for an old love. Take me as I am, let me go. Take me as I am, let me go.
Here's a guy that when I first came to Nashville, he was kind of like a father figure to me. Now he looks younger than I do, and I ain't got that figured out. But I did 70 of his songs, and I think that's some kind of record. And I ought to get some kind of an award from Harlan Howard.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.
The thing I remember most about Sue Brewer was I was living out in Madison back in the early 60s, and I'd get kind of restless, and I'd run down to Tootsie's looking for Roger or Willie or Hank Cochran or just any of the guys to be around with. And of course, they'd run us off from Tootsie's at midnight, and we didn't have no place to go, so we'd grab a six-pack or two and head up for Sue's and continue on into the night. And we all loved that gal because she supplied us a place to be. Here's one of the songs I kind of tested on you back then. The bills are all due, and the babies need shoes, and I'm busting. Cotton is down to a quarter pound, and I'm busting. Got a cow that's gone dry, and a hen that won't lay. A big stack of bills that gets bigger each day. The county's gonna haul my belongings away. I'm busting. Now, Lord, I'm no thief, but a man can go wrong when he's busted. The food that we canned last summer is gone, I'm busted. Now the fields are all bare and the cotton won't grow. Me and my family's gotta pack up and go. I'll make a living, but where, I don't know, 'cause I'm busted. We'll be right back, folks, right after.
This next guy, a guitar pull wouldn't be a guitar pull without him, because in America, I think one of the things that, one of the great things to do is listen to Mickey Newberry sing.
Oh, boy. Too late now. Thank you, Willie. She slipped into the silence of my dreams last night, wandering from room to room, turning on each light. Her laughter spilled like water from the river to the sea. I was swept away from sadness, clinging to her memory. Sweet memory.
Well,
sweet memory.
I've been looking for an opportunity to introduce this guy, because, and you'll see why. Anytime you ever, if you ever have a song you're not quite sure of, a record, take it and let Kilgore listen to it. Kilgore says, in between each line, it's fantastic, great, a smash hit. Now, get serious and be funny, Kilgore.
Thank you very much, Waylon, and all my honored friends and guests. I'm so glad you came to honor me here. This place is, well, it brings back so many memories of all the fights I had with all my wives. You know, when a man fights with a woman, he has got to have a place to rest. And I found a lot of good friends resting. Mac Vickery had broke up with his second or third wife, and I had just got handed the big paper from the deputy sheriff to move out from my either fourth or fifth wife. So, yeah, and they told me never come back to Sumner County ever again. And they use that word again. When they say again, you know they're serious. That means hillbilly don't ever come back. So Vickery and I was talking it over. Farron Young had passed out from the exhaustion. Picking and singing, you understand? And so Mac and I wrote a song right here. And, you know, when you write a song, we wrote it real quick, and then we did it over and over to polish it up, and Farron was going... And every now and then, he would raise up and say, hey, that's pretty good, that's pretty good. He recorded the song, and it was a top 10 song for me and Vickery, and thanks to Farron Young. Wrote this for all of our wives.
Loving me to you seems such a bother. Well, you made it easy for me to love another. So don't you blame her for stealing me. You know you let her. And where your love stopped, she went a little bit farther. You changed so much, I was more at ease with a stranger. It wasn't so hard, our love was already in danger. Now don't you blame her for stealing me, you know you let her. And where your love stopped, she went a little bit farther. She went a little bit farther, made me feel loved. She considered my feelings, she's all I'm thinking of. So don't you blame her for stealing me, you know you let her. And where your love stopped, she went a little bit farther. Yes, where your love stopped, she went a little bit farther.
All right.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Unbelievable.
This next guy, we spent 20-some-odd years together. He helped develop the sound that I got in music, and he was my friend, still is my friend. But, you know, he played drums behind me so long that he didn't even recognize me unless my back was turned to him. It's Richie Albright.
Oh, how you doing, Mike? Boy, it's a flash being back here with Merle and everybody. It's getting almost like the old boar's nest, let me tell you. I'm like Vickery. I was just a piece of furniture there because I lived right behind the boar's nest for quite a few years. And kind of took Mikey, her son, as my little brother, you know. Still got to keep tabs on him and everything. But this
I
is.
You were my song plugger.
I had to take all the song Chris's songs to Waylon because he was too bashful to pitch them to me at the time. It's great to see everybody come together on such a great occasion and everything. I think that y'all do a great thing. We'll be right back with more of old Waylon and old.
Hey, he's a lover, fighter, a wild horse rider, and a big game hunter, mountain climber, hell of a good old boy, and one of my best friends, Hank Williams Jr.
Thank you, Waylon. Well, I'm just so proud to be here, and I've been blessed in a lot of ways. Number one, I was blessed because I was the son of Hank Williams. Number two, I was really blessed being around all these great songwriters and musicians I could steal from, which I stole everything I could from.
I'm still doing that.
I want to try to pay back a little bit to some of you guys. All my settled down,
yeah,
and seem to be more in the laid back songs. Nobody wants to get drunk and get loud. Everybody wants to go back home. I myself have seen my wilder days, and I have seen my name at the top of the page. But I need to find some friends just to run around. Nobody wants to get high on the town. George Jones, I'm glad to see he's finally getting straight. Waylon staying home and loving Jesse more these days. And nobody wants to get drunk and to get oom-bombed away. And all my rowdy friends have settled down. I think I know what my daddy meant when he sang about the lost highway. Old Chris is a movie star, Willie's in L.A. Johnny Cash don't act like he did back in 68. Nobody wants to get drunk and get loud. All my rowdy friends have settled down. Yeah, me and my rowdy friends, we've rowdied on down.
Right now, Mac Wiseman, I think everybody loves to hear you sing. I know I do.
Yeah.
Like to do Jimmy Brown, the newsboy.
Oh, all right.
I didn't mean all of that. I sell the morning paper, sir. My name is Jimmy Brown. Everybody knows I'm the newsboy of the town. You'll hear me yelling, Morning Star, as I run along the street. I have no hat upon my head, no shoes upon my feet. I have no hat upon my head, no shoes upon my feet. I'm awful cold and hungry, sir, my clothes are torn and thin. I wander about from place to place, my daily bread to win. Never mind, sir, how I look, don't look at me and frown. I sell the morning paper, sir, my name is Jimmy Brown. I sell the morning paper, sir. My name is Jimmy Brown. Y'all pay attention, I'm gonna ask questions. Like, how does he do it? My father died a drunkard, sir, I've heard my mother say. And I am helping mother, sir, as I journey on my way. Mother always tells me, sir, I've nothing in this world to lose. I'll get a place in heaven, sir, to sell the gospel news. Never mind, sir, how I look, don't look at me and frown. I sell the morning paper, sir, my name is Jimmy Brown. I sell the morning paper, sir, my name is Jimmy Brown.
You know, we've tried to recapture here what we used to do. And I'll tell you one thing, I think we should do it a lot more. And I think I'd love to do it, because I love being with all you guys. And I mean, like, everybody was, I mean, just all for this. They all wanted to stand up and be counted. And you've done yourself proud. Here's a song that I think all of us saw these days in the early days. I've been chasing the big wheels all over Nashville, waiting for my big break to come. Living on ketchup soup, homemade crackers and Kool-Aid. I'll be a star tomorrow, but today I'm a Nashville bum. Well, here's a song I wrote by myself, note for note, with a lot of hype it might make number one. You can change a word or two, and I'll give half of it to you. I'll be a star tomorrow, but today I'm a Nashville bum. Right now, this next guy I want to introduce, his name was Mac when he lived over at Sue Brewer's. He lived at the Boar's Nest, and up until the time Sue moved from there. And just recently, I realized that ever since then, he's been living with me. But he's changed his name to Basil now. Basil McDavid.
Thank you, Waylon. Boy, there's so many famous songwriters here tonight. I'm the only one I've never heard of. But I came to town in Nashville in 1966 with you. And I used to drink all the time. But when I came to Nashville, I started taking those pills, those White Crosses. And I was at Sue's all the time just because I just enjoyed being up. I lived there at Sue's when we weren't out on the road, but she was a good friend. You know, I was thinking of one word to describe Sue, I think, more than anything. Sue was country. Now, but when we came to town, and the first day I was there was on a Thanksgiving. We left town that day, and Sue invited all the band up for a Thanksgiving dinner. And when we went out on the road, I wondered, you know, why she would do something like that. She didn't even know me, but... I'm glad we're here tonight doing this. And it only take one person for all of us to be here, a thought, and that was you. You thought of it, Waylon, and I'm glad you did. Yeah. We'll be right back.
If you're ready for the pro-quality alternative to rakes and brooms, listen up. That's an easy starting echo you hear. That's an easy starting, easy handling echo you hear. And it'll make a pro out of you.
I hear you.
Take it from Dick Butkus.
Save $50 on Echo's handheld power blower. Sale priced at $119.95.
Available at Coast to Coast, Seymour, St. Matthew's Feed and Seed, Louisville and Crestwood, and Stess Hardware, Crestwood.
Hi, Louise.
Oh, Harry, with your cigars and these musty odors, we need Arm & Hammer Maximum Strength Carpet Deodorizer.
For tough odors.
Works longer, costs less than these, has more odor-destroying ingredient than these combined. And while these sit on top, Arm & Hammer Carpet Deodorizer penetrates, destroys deep-down odors, even tough, musty odors. Works longer, costs less.
The whole room's fresh.
Works better, costs less. Now, extra value in a new, larger family size.
Do you think people are loyal to Charmin only when I'm around?
watch my hidden camera.
I want to take away your pack of Charm and give you two packs of this major brand instead.
No, that's okay.
What are you doing?
Well, this is what I use. It's very soft. It's absorbent. It's economical. It's squeezably soft. Feel it. Squeezably soft. Feel that. Doesn't have it. Squeeze this, and you wouldn't buy anything else.
My boss would never believe this.
Gotcha.
Squeezably soft Charmin. Once it's gotcha, it's gotcha,
you
right?
Bet.
And now there's new stronger Charmin. Stronger when wet than any other tissue.
Don't miss the fun when couples battle it out for big prizes on the all-new Newlywed Game. Every weekday at 5 on Wave TV 3.
Thank you very much. Right now, I think I'll show you a photo album from the mid-60s and show you what we all looked like back then. Here's Way Moore with Basil McDavid back at J.D.'s in Phoenix. There's the sheriff, Farron Young, back when he wasn't as good-looking as he is today. There's Roger Miller, shoveling some doo-wack-a-doo. Here's Shel Silverstein with Sue and Vince Matthews and yours truly. I think we just pulled a good one on old Johnny Cash or something like that. And here's my first hero, country music's own E.T., the late and great Ernest Tubb. Here's Chris. He's already looking like a movie star, huh? Here's Webb Pierce. He used to work at Sears and Roebuck in the mid-60s. He was probably thinking about buying it right about there. Here's starving, skinny Merle Kilgore. Now here's Merle after he'd been eating a little bit better. And it looks like Hank Cochran hadn't been laying off the grits and gravy either. And here's another early hero of mine, the late, great Lefty Frizzell. Here's an early George Jones. Man, Chris could have landed a helicopter on that flat top. How about Mel Tillis? He must have borrowed that coat from Porter Wagner. That's Bo Cephas. Looks like Porter was out of coats by then, huh? I wonder if Webb Pierce ever loaned that car to Porter. Here's someone who joined us for an all-night picking session every once in a while, Harry Picker. And here's another one of our Harry Pickers, Basil McDavid. Here's Red Lane before he jumped out of Uncle Harvey's plane. Seriously, here he is playing at the opening night of Possum Holler's Nightclub. Here's George Jones giving Sue the key to Possum Holler. And that's Sue welcoming Roy Acuff to Possum Holler. Here's Willie back in the days when he was pitching songs. Now, I don't want to leave the impression that things were bad back in them days, but I was even cutting Richie Albright's hair. Here's Mickey Newberry signing with Wesley Rose at Acuff Rose. Here's old Mac Vickery and Elvis taking a break from touch football at Graceland. Here's Harlan Howard thinking up one of them great songs. And here he is trying to teach me one of them. Here's my better half. She keeps on getting better too. Jesse Colton. Here's Mac Wiseman. He's the one that first recorded Susan's Floor. And look at old Tater. Little Jimmy Dickens, all dressed up. And there she is, the one that we're thinking of tonight, Sue Brewer.
Like crippled ships, we made it through the storm. Finally reached a quiet shore. The homeless found a home on Susan's floor. Now that the songs are sweet, seems like a band should greet her, thank her for the favors that she gave. Strangers, we came with our heads bowed in the rain to her door.
sat and sang our songs on Susan's floor.
Didn't seem so cold and tired, stretched out before her fire, rolling smokes and drinking up her wine. I remember candlelights, singing till we couldn't sing no more, and falling warm asleep on Susan's floor. In the morning we'd go on buying kingdoms with a song, knowing we'd be back in just a while, healing in the sunshine of her smile. Now the times and songs have passed, older eyes start looking back, reliving all the days and all the nights. Where I'd be today if I had only stayed one night more, sang just one more song on Susan's floor. I wonder where I'd be today if I had only stayed one night more, sat and sang our songs on Susan's floor.
You know, thank you. There's another good thing that came out of those days. Sue Brewer's son, Mike. We'd like to introduce Mike to you right now. Stand up, son. Great.
And hi, Mike. You know, struggling songwriters aren't a thing of the past. There's a ton of new ones coming up every day, and the purpose of this tribute is to set up a Sue Brewer Fund to help those new writers, and we're working along with the Songwriters Guild to have this new fund, and it'll help today's songwriters find at least a semblance of the help that Sue Brewer gave to all of us. And who knows, they might one day find another Waylon or another Willie out there somewhere. Heaven forbid.
A buddy of mine. I once wrote a song about him. He's a legend in his own time. This is George Jones.
He said, I love you till I die. She told him, forget time. I watched the years pass slowly by. She still prayed on his mind. Kept her picture on his wall. Went half crazy now and then. But he still loved her through it all. Kept hoping she'd come back again. Found love letters by his bed. Did it 1962. He had underlined in red every single. But I didn't see no tears. All dressed up to go away. First time I'd seen him smile in years. Upon his door,
He stopped loving her today. You know, she came back today for the last time. Oh, and we all wondered if she would. And it kept running through my mind. Well, this time he's over her for good. Today.
Thank you very much. I don't know about the rest of y'all, but I really want to hear Waylon and Jesse sing.
You know, I'm really glad that tonight we're celebrating Sue Brewer. It seems like no matter where you come from, when you first come to Nashville, you need someone to like you right off, because it's kind of a tough town. And that's the way it was with Sue and me. She liked me right off, and she let me know it. And something about that made me feel real important. She had a kindness about her and a compassion gift is what she had. I wish I could explain to you how it'd feel when she'd look at you with those eyes. It'd make you feel real big. And I'm so proud I knew her. So proud she was a friend of mine. And I know it makes Waylon feel so good to try to pass on her kind of compassion and kindness to others. And I wrote this song just about the time I came to know Sue.
You're looking for someone who's got it all to give. You're looking for someone who won't care how you live. You're looking for someone who won't need love from you. I ain't the one. I ain't the one.
Well, you're looking for someone to dry your tears when you cry. Looking for someone to turn his back each time you lie. Looking for someone to walk on and walk by. I ain't the one. I ain't the one.
I ain't the one who's gonna do just what you want.
You know, we'll be back right after this message. Even me. And they call me No Show Jones.
It was pretty well known that I was a big fan of Hank Williams. Well, I'm a big fan and a friend of our next guest. Here's Hank Williams Jr.
Hank Williams Jr.
friends are coming over tonight. Are coming over tonight. My party pants way out in the woods. It's a long way from here to Hollywood. I got some natural queens out on the floor. Miss Mississippi just walked through the door. I got a little girl who you can jump out, you can jump in, you can do anything that you want to do. Uh-uh, don't you step on my cowboy boot. Do you want to drink? Woo! Do you want to party? Hey, honey, this is old Hank. Yeah, we're gonna get your motor started. You got a pig in the ground, beer's on ice. All my rowdy friends are coming over tonight.
Here's my brother of the road for 19 years, Merle Kilgore.
These are my people, I tell you. Hello, everybody. I want to do for you a song I recorded about, oh, 3 years ago. And Hank Williams Jr. and Johnny Cash recorded this song with me. Since Johnny Cash is not here tonight, Hank is, I decided to do all three parts. And the song is Mr. Garfield Been Shot Down Low. Now me and my brother were walking by the station when I heard a shot ring out. I asked a crying lady, what's all the commotion? She said, Mr. Garfield shot down low. And Mr. Garfield shot down. Well, the soldiers carried him up to a big house. He was tended by his doctors and his wife. He said, Lucretia, honey, now if I don't make it, you can't pull a single harness all your life. That's what he said. Can't pull a single harness all your life. Hey, Mr. Garfield been shot down, shot down, shot down. Garfield's been shot down low. Is shut down low. If you love country music, let me hear you say, Stewie! Right. Yeah. Next morning, me and brother went back up to the house. Seen the flag of blind at half mast. A soldier boy, is it true? Is he gone? He said, yes, the president has passed. Lord, Lord. Yes, Mr. Garfield has passed. I said, who is to blame? What is the assassin's name? Not putting Mr. Garfield in the ground. He said his name was Charlie Gitto. Charlie Gitto's done shot a good man down. Lord, Lord. Charlie Gitto's done shot a good man down. Mr. Garfield's been shot down, shot down, shot down. Garfield's been shot down low. Hey, Mr. Garfield's been shot down, shot down, shot down. Garfield's been shot down low. Well, this is the part I said, Johnny, if you please come over to the microphone and read these lyrics here.
and sing this part. He studied them over and he said, oh yeah, I can relate to that. I definitely will sing that on your record. And this is the way that Johnny did it. He had to cough a little bit. Excuse me. We want you to understand the moral of this all and what we've been talking about. They killed the Kennedys, Dr. King, shot Reagan and the Pope. They all ought to be death row bound. Lord, Lord, but they're still breathing air and walking. Ought to be lined up and shot down, shot down, shot down. Lined up and shot down low. Shot down other folks.
Friends, we'll be back right after this message. And if Waylon's coming back, you can bet I am.
Right now, I'm going to get Willie to come back out here. Good to see you, Hank.
Good to see you, Waylon.
It's good to be here.
Yeah, it's good to be here. You want to do that song we rehearsed?
Yeah, we can either do that or rehearse the one we sung.
That's easier. I like your idea.
Cowboys ain't easy to love and no harder to hold. They'd rather give you a song than diamond to gold.
Long star bell buckles and old faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day. And if you don't understand him and he don't die young, he will probably just ride away.
Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive their old folks. Let them be doctors and lawyers and sons. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. They'll never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love.
Cowboys like smoky old pool rooms and clear mountain mornings. Little warm puppies and children and girls of the night.
Them that don't know him won't like him, and them that do sometimes won't know how to take him. He ain't wrong, he's just different, but his pride won't let him do things to make you think he's right.
Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks. Let them be doctors and lawyers and sons. Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. They'll never stay home and they're always alone. Be by with someone they love.
We want to thank all of you for joining us here tonight and this special tribute to our old friend, Sue Brewer. Right now, I'd like to get everybody to come back out here and join me on stage. And I want to give all my old friends a double thank you tonight. First, for joining in on the show and for helping set up with the Songwriters Guild, the Sue Brewer Fund, to help new writers in town.
For those of you who would like to make contributions, they can be made payable to the Sue Brewer Fund of the Songwriters Guild Foundation. 50 Music Square West, Suite 207, Nashville, 37203, Tennessee. Telephone number 615-329-1782.
Old friends, pitching pennies in the park. Playing croquet
till it's dark, old friends. Mm-hmm, old friends. Swapping lies of lives and loves, pitching popcorn to the doves, old friends. Up to watch a bird.